The proposal that we made on the post-Cotonou are at the same time important because of the very nature of this partnership, which is the oldest one that the European Union has with a big number, actually the biggest number of developing countries in the world. We set up this partnership in Lomé in 75. It was the most advanced partnership between a group of developed countries, as we used to say at the time, and developing countries. The biggest and the most advanced, where concepts that now are quite familiar and that we are repeating also in the new consensus, like ownership, like partnership, co-decision, respect of each other, solidarity, were already embedded in Lomé, in the Convention of Lomé. Therefore, there is something powerful in thinking about what next. It's also true that in these days, this model is also under stress because it has turned to be, for too long, a partnership for spending money. And this is not sustainable anymore because we are, as we said, talking about the new consensus, talking about the EU global strategy for the European Union in the world, following President Juncker's 10th point in its mandate. Therefore, what we'll do is to propose to our ACP friends to think strategically together, to set up political objectives together, to set up procedures which are much more effective than those existing today, which are cumbersome, which are lengthy, which are bureaucratic, in order to do together. And then, and only then, to talk about money, because money is a function of our agreement in political terms, in terms of objectives. At the same time, our experience has shown that the ACP is a powerful umbrella, but it is increasingly, let's say, creating some problem in order to deal with the regional component of this group. Creating problem in the sense, and the best example is Africa, because schemes through which we are interacting with our African friends are, instead of remaining only under the ACP framework, as it used to be for decades, now have been set up in various schemes. In particular, I refer to the EU-Africa joint strategy. Therefore, we will hope we can get at the end is to have a renewed partnership which is based on common values, common rules, common principles, which are valid for everybody, but then to develop regional pillars, the African one, the Caribbean one, the Pacific one, in which we should be able to deal much more concretely with the specificity of each group and offering opportunities to other countries which are belonging to the same regions but which are not part and will never be part of the ACP group to cooperate. The new partnership is based on shared objective, and the European interests are therefore fully put on the table and transformed, I hope, in shared objective. When we say which is our European interest is to help in stabilizing the world, in promote democracy, in creating conditions for development which is sustainable, to create more justice, to realize that, for example, migratory pressures which are not managed but which are the result of fears, of poverty, of manipulation of traffickers, are a common objective. And therefore, we are working in order to to define these objectives together, like fighting against terrorism, for example, our common security. We cannot imagine that we have interest which can be defined alone and can be promoted, implemented alone. Our common interest to create a better condition of life everywhere in the world in order to have a world which has a future, these are our interests. And I think that we have to discuss this interest with our partners and at the end to discover that we have one agenda and therefore to set up one partnership in order to deliver in this agenda. It's not a question to impose any interest of ours on them. It's a question to sit, to analyze which are the common challenges in the world. But certainly this will be done probably in a more explicit way than in the past. In the past, when there is a You know, people which are living together under the same roof for several decades, sometimes routine is taking over. It's a bit like in a marriage, you know. We have to inject a moment of rethinking about this. Go back to fundamentals. Why we are doing that together? Why the biggest and still richest group of the North, as we used to say, the European Union member states, and the biggest group of the South, the ACP countries, should sit together and contribute in setting an agenda for a better world in the framework of the Agenda 2030. Ça sera partie de la discussion. Je me souviens encore, il y a quelques années, quand on a commencé à négocier ces schémas régionaux, qu'on appelle l'Economic Partnership Agreement, les accords de partenariat économique, il y avait un moment de tension et de suspicion mutuelle. Dire voilà, tout d'un coup, l'Union européenne parle un langage de libre-échange, alors que jusqu'à présent, on avait parlé un langage de protection. Je crois que maintenant, après pas mal d'années, non seulement de discussions, mais de conclusions de certains accords dans les Caraïbes, dans l'Afrique de l'Est, j'espère que ça puisse avancer, dans l'Afrique du Sud, je crois que les termes du problème ont été mieux cernés. L'agenda que nous avions proposé était une agenda qui était basée sur l'intégration régionale. Et pourquoi? Parce que c'est dans notre DNA. On a vu qu'en intégrant les marchés au niveau régional et subrégional, les conditions pour l'activité économique sont meilleures. Quand on a un seul tarif douanier, quand on n'a pas d'obstacles tarifaires et non tarifaires au marché intérieur, aux échanges de marchandises, de biens, de services, la libre circulation des travailleurs qui est fondamentale pour l'Union est la même chose aussi dans d'autres pays. Donc l'agenda de support au processus d'intégration régionale qui est fait au niveau et de manière différenciée dans chaque région des pays ACP a commencé maintenant à être comprise. Et aussi le fait de comprendre qu'il faut accompagner ces processus. Il ne s'agit pas de libéraliser, il s'agit d'aider les pays ACP et les schémas régionaux en question à produire un cadre pour que les entreprises soient compétitives, qui puissent avoir un accès au marché global de manière plus efficace. Ce n'est pas avec une protection ou un protectionnisme qui est anachronistique. Ce n'est pas avec de l'aide qui ne sera jamais suffisante à protéger les ressortissants, les citoyens, les producteurs, les entreprises de ces pays. La seule manière pour avancer est celle de, ensemble, construire et partager notre expérience d'un marché intérieur et de investir dans la valeur ajoutée que chaque schéma régional peut produire pour les entreprises de ces régions. Donc, dans le cadre du partenariat post-Cotonou, les réalités d'intégration régionale vont avoir encore plus importance, vont avoir encore plus support et vont avoir encore plus interaction avec ce que nous considérons être la manière pour faire ensemble. C'est promouvoir l'activité économique, promouvoir les investissements, créer les conditions pour la création d'emplois. Ça, c'est l'objectif. Tout le reste, les moyens sont à discuter, mais ça, c'est l'objectif. Et le seul objectif est de faire en sorte qu'il y ait plus de compétitivité, plus de valeur ajoutée et plus de capacité de production par tous les producteurs où ils se trouvent.